Good afternoon today to our next Open-E webinar. We are going to talk about how DSS V6 will operate together with uninterruptible power supply. And in some situations, you may have also a power supply which doesn't have the network connection, but it's, you are able to script and you may issue the shutdown command in such case from your script. So very often our customers are using this opportunity. This is why we would like to also show this one more time. We are repeating this webinar. It was done maybe 2 years ago, and I would like to show you what you need to configure and how you need to use the UPS settings and DSS settings and how you configure the script. In our case, I will show P-Link, so I will show you also how to download and how to use it. Okay, so I have already downloaded a presentation which is available on our web. So let me show you. When you go to our web and in support, library and how to resources, okay, in section others, you will see exactly this presentation, okay, how to configure SNMP enabled UPS. And in section snapshots, this is also example remote snapshot control with API or command line interface from DSS. In this example, we show how to start and stop and check status of snapshot, but this will be almost identical when you want to issue a shutdown or a reboot command, right? So this presentation is as well good. I have prepared one DSS running here, which is enough for our demonstration today. And I have also SNMP powered, so the uninterruptible power supply, which has a special interface with the Ethernet port, so we can manage this UPS via web GUI, and we can set IP because it is using a network card adapter. So local address is set to 192.168.0.251, and our DSS is using a 192.168.0.220 standard default interface. Okay. Okay, system and network status. Here we see that the UPS is now in status OK. I have a power switch with me, so I can switch it off. So after switching off, I must see the situation now. Then UPS is on battery right now. Okay, so when I go to status hardware, then because I'm connected right now, so here you will see there is also on battery, and I have a fresh message. I will switch back power. Okay, switching power back. It is now, after a few seconds, it will become green again. So we just wait. And now you see there is a green status. And then on DSS, we just need to wait until the refresh is done. And now you see online. So whether is OL means on lines and OB means on battery. And we have here under O, that was my configuration was, I was keeping too long time because my configuration was 30 seconds only. So now what happened? I will ping our 192.168.0.220. Okay. So it was a short time set in our system, and in the meantime, by meantime, the system was already shut down because the before I was starting the webinar session, I was setting this completely. Once the system will be rebooted, but now it was shut down, so I will have to power on. So please give me a few seconds. Okay, I just power on the system. Of course, in the praxis, you may set a longer time than just 30 seconds because your UPS probably has a, you know, powerful battery and it can stand maybe 5 or 10 minutes. But for our demo, I have taken 30 seconds, that we don't need to wait a long time for the shutdown. Okay, so we will start the explanation. I will do exactly the same what it is in our demo, you know, step by step. So first I will introduce to you what kind of uninterruptible power supply we are using. So in our case we are using online brand, but it will work exactly the same way with any other brand which has option to install this SNMP powered Ethernet port. Okay, so we need to configure this UPS adapter, then we will need to configure DSS, and then we just need to test it. Okay, so there are a few screens you need to go and find on your web GUI, because it can be that your web GUI may be different. So you need to just set the IP address, you need to set SNMP traps to version 1, and you need to set the IP address of DSS and you know, community public. So let us go to our web, so network and security. Here we see that I have set IP address for our UPS. I have set here 1 for trap version, and in SNMP settings I have set IP address of our DSS, and the community I'm using here is public. Please do not mix with the SNMP settings on the DSS side, because on the DSS side we are using another instance of SNMP which is running to collect log statistics. So this is a different instance which is used only for the UPS. Okay, so having this done, please always try to find the save configuration, because after you've done the changes, you must save the configuration. This module is not dynamic, so you need to click on the save button. Then you need to confirm that the saving is done. So it is now trying to save. Once the settings is saved, we must get the prompt that the settings is already saved, so we just need to wait. Okay, now we see configuration saved successfully. Okay. So now we can, you know, reboot the system to make sure that the settings are exactly as we have saved. Okay. So after rebooting, it takes maybe 1 minute, and after rebooting, I'm sure that my settings are now running as I was configuring. Okay. So we just wait 1 minute. By meantime, let us see whether DSS is already not yet. So it is still starting. Probably it is pinging already. So as you see, it is already pinging. So within some seconds, we will have it back. Okay. Now we can click on reload. Okay, it is still not up. Okay. We need to be patient, it takes up to 2 minutes. Okay, so that's the case. The UPS is already up and running, and we see the status is okay, right? So let us see. The DSS is already auch, is already auch, also back. Okay, so let us log in. Okay, so the settings for the UPS you will find under a setup hardware. Okay, under setup hardware is our settings, and I, as I mentioned, it was 30 seconds only. And this is why when I was switching off, and then 30 seconds was passing away, and then shutdown signal was sent to the DSS already. And the status we can observe in the status hardware. Okay, the first UPS show the status hardware, so it is not we will need to probably wait a second. Okay, so in the events we see the first event, which was as a 1610, so it was a UPS on battery. Okay. And as you see, 1611, 27 plus 8, so it was probably 1 second too long. It was coming back, but it came back maybe 1 second too late because the shutdown command was already sent to the DSS. Okay, so after I'm, you know, when I have a fresh configuration, I have nothing here. Okay, so the first thing, I need to enable UPS. And SNMP powered settings we have only in the the second MGE settings, so I need to select the MGE. Okay, single is okay. Then SNMP, that's the last position in the settings. Then default is a 5 minutes, but in our case we will select 30 seconds because we don't want to wait long. Just anyway, we were showing this that the shutdown was working, so I can set maybe 2 minutes now. I will power off and power on, then we will see that the messages are coming to the DSS. Okay, so apply. After applying the settings, we need to go to the status and hardware and check for the hardware status. Here, you need to be a little bit patient because after applying the settings, it takes something almost 1 minute to log in to the UPS and show this line on our GUI. So you see, we were waiting just a while, and now the system shows online and shows battery charge. So it is exactly the same what is on the web GUI. Okay. So when I will again go to hardware and disable this, okay, apply. So when I go to status, hardware, again it is disappearing, and when I enable this again, MGE, okay, 5 minutes is also okay, good. Apply. Okay, this is apply already done, and I go to hardware, and you see that's the little problem, that it is not showing immediately the status. Please be aware about it, and then please just wait up to 1 minute till the status will appear, because it just negotiating with the UPS right now. If this will not appear within 2 minutes, then it's something wrong. Okay, so now it's appear, you see, and then we are sure that the connection is done properly, and we can make one more test. So making one more test, I will clean these messages to make sure that we have nothing inside. Okay, so our messages envelope is empty. I will switch off. Okay, so I hear already that the UPS is on the signal that it's off. Again, it takes some seconds until the status is refreshed on the DSS. Okay, now we see there is status on battery, and we can see that the UPS send us status on battery. I will show you again the, okay, you see on the GUI we have also on battery. I switch power back. So the web GUI should recognize a bit faster. Okay, we have green now, and on DSS we have also online now. So when I switch back, we have another message. The system is online power now. Okay, so this is the way how you can test it, and when you switch off for 5 minutes in this case, because now we have 5 minutes, then the DSS must power down. So this was quite easy settings. The only warning for you, wait for the status up to 1 minute to show up when the settings was posted. Okay, and I would like to show you that in the administrator settings we have also kind of SNMP settings. Okay, there is a SNMP settings, but these settings has this SNMP instance has nothing to do with the UPS configuration. So this is another instance which is used for collecting statistics. So when I go to status statistics, so you will see we are collecting some information about the system, and then we are using this also, using SNMP, but this is a second instance, so has nothing to do with this instance SNMP, which is communicating with the UPS. Okay, let us see if there is still no question. It means today we have very simple webinar. Now, next thing I want to show to you is how to remotely shut down or reboot DSS from your script. So in order to do it, you need to go to a setup administrator. And very last option is here, a command line API configuration. So when you start, then it is not enabled, okay? So we will need to enable this. What we need to enter the IP from which it is allowed to send such a command. You can set your IP or some range of IP, okay? If you leave it empty, then everyone will be entitled to send the command. So I'm leaving empty, so it is in this case, the signal can come from any IP. I need to enter password, of course, so I will just set admin. Oh. Admin, apply. So now it is enabled, but we will need a key in order to run a so-called non-interactive mode from script, because without a key it will prompt you and ask you for the password. So we don't want to be asked for the password, because when we issue the script command, we want that it will just run. So in this case, we generate and download the key. Or I can download the key when I was generating this before already. When I generate and download, so I will have a new key generated. Okay. So now I'm saving the key. That's the key 844 on the end. Okay. And I will need to, you know, copy this key to my directory when I have a pilling installed. Okay. So I copy. Okay. And I have it on my drive D. I created UPS. So here there was another key which I was using before, so paste. So this another key I will just delete it, and the so-called private key I will delete as well. You know, here in order to issue the command, you can click on question mark, and in question mark we explain how to issue the command using SSH. Okay, without key, so you will be asked for password here, and here there is a one more command with the key. Okay, you see the minus I and the key. Okay, so minus 2 is the protocol, and minus P is a port number, and minus L or dash L is a username, and it is always API here, and then the command. Okay, so that's the syntax of our command line, right? So as this is for the for the SSH, but under Windows sometimes SSH has a problem. So I do strongly recommend to use a pelling instead of SSH client. So you can go to web and download the pelling. If you okay, forget where you can find the the client. Here in the remote console access, we have the description how to run console tools, and these console tools can be run with so-called PuTTY client, and along with this PuTTY client, there is also a kind of SSH client. Okay, so you go to PuTTY.nl for Netherlands and click on download. And in download section, next to the PuTTY, we have our PLink. Okay, so you need to download the PLink exe, and you need to download the PuTTY gen exe, because the key which we are generating doesn't work with PLink, so we will need to convert the key to so-called private key. Okay, so both files here I can just copy them. Okay, I copy the files and I save somewhere on the disk. So in my case, I save in the UPS. So I will just paste. I overwrite because I was having them before already. Okay. Okay, good. So PuTTY actually I don't really need right now, but just in case. Okay. So PLink and the PuTTY again. The PLink will need the private key, so I have here the SSH kind of key, so I will need to run a PuTTY gen and create a so-called private key. So when I run PuTTY gen, run, I just need to load only, so I click on load, and in load I will need to select, I want to see all files, and then I select my DSS generated key, right? Okay, so open. So this is imported the foreign key, and now I need to save this as a private key. Okay, so save. It is asking me, are you sure you want to save this key without password to protect it? Yes, I want to do it. Okay. So now I just need to enter the key name. So I will just enter just a key. Okay. So you see, now I have another file which is called key PPK. Okay. And I can use it this already for the PLink command. Okay. So now I will switch to the command line. So the okay. So now we see we have a key.ppk, so that's the private key. We have PLink here, and then so we are just ready to issue the command. So PLink, you know, Windows is now very nice because it is working as a Linux. So the tabulator key, when I click tabulator, it is just you know, putting the rest. So it is nice, right? You don't need to type everything. So when I just typed, I got the help, and this help is, you know, the syntax of this command is almost identical as SSH. So in SSH, when I click on our question mark here, the SSH state, you know, syntax is like this. So you put the SSH command, okay? The next one is a dash I for path, dash 2 for the you know, number of the protocol and the protocol version, the small p for the port number, okay, then minus l for username, and username is always API, and the command. Okay, so in our case I will just put PLink Okay, dash minus E for the key, so I just put key and the tabulator, so it is, you know, taking the whole file name already. The protocol number is 2, the port number, now be careful please, the port number is a capital P, it's not a small p, but the capital P, as you see here on the top, the capital P is the, for the port number, okay? So the port number, our port number is just 22223. You know, the port number we are using for the remote console default is 5 tools, and here we have 4 tools and 3 on the end, just the next one, okay? So 2222 and 3, that's the port number, and please remember capital P. Then username is API, okay, and now the host, you can just enter the IP of the host, so 192.168.0.220, and the command, and the first command we are going to use is a help, okay. When you are running this very first time, it will ask you whether you want to cache it, so just yes, and that's it. So now you see it is DSS is answering us with the pre-built you know, command set, API command line command set, which you can use. So in an example, step-by-step example, we were showing how to use the snapshot task command, but today we will just use a shutdown or reboot. You know, reboot, shutdown is here and reboot is here. I will just do reboot, then I will need to, don't need to go to the power on this again. So now I will just issue this command one more time, but with a reboot, okay? Okay, so I just enter reboot, ping 192.168.0.220. So we see that it is still answering because the reboot takes some time, maybe 20 to 30 seconds. Sometimes good idea is also to put the console, but it is too late because it is just already disconnected. Sometimes it is good when you test the reboot, when you start the console tools, then you will see on the console tools that the shutdown command was issued as well. Okay, so here, we just wait another 2-3 minutes and the system will come back. Of course, in your case, when you will want to issue the shutdown command, then you need to put in any scripting language. It can be, you know, DOS, Bash, it can be Python or anything what you are using. Okay, so now it is rebooting. Okay, so I just encourage you to download the PLink and check this key generator by yourself, switching back to the private key and using the command lines. It is quite easy, and you know, PLink is as good because it works in any Windows without any problem. With when you download SSH client for Windows, you may have problems, especially on Windows 7, because or maybe by meantime the version is already properly updated. I was having some bad experience running, you know, SSH on Windows.